Hello and welcome back everyone to our next session on Node.js programming. So first we'll see what we did in the previous session. So in the previous session we just ran a command to print the hello world. So this was our one line of code that was printing hello world on our output stream, that is on our console. Now what you want to do exactly, you want to show it is that how is a JavaScript able to interact with our operating system and able to access the output stream and print onto the output stream. Now, as I had earlier told you that this, our JavaScript is basically the V8 engine that is built in C++, so inherently it's executing the C code. So these all console.log and all are wrapper on top of Java, on top of this standard output stream that interacting with the output parameters or that is printing on the output stream or not. So what we'll do is that we'll just delete the statement and try to run and interact with the process, do the same thing. But what exactly inherently console.log does, we'll do that. And it is stdout process.stdout dot we'll try to write something onto the standard output stream and say we'll write the same thing. We'll say hello world. Okay, we'll save it and then we'll try to run it. So how do we run it? We'll run it using the same. We'll clear a screen first of all. We'll try to do and it will be node 1 and see, we ran it. Now there is one difference in this when we do it with respect to console.log. You would see that there is a new line missing after we printing hello world. Now that new line is additionally added by console.log. So but what process.stdout is doing? Now what process.stdout is doing is that it's printing onto the output stream and start writing anything after the just hello world. If you want to write slash and we can obviously write a new line character over there. Now this is how we dealt with output. Now we'll just see how do we get the parameters that are passed to our application when we run the Node.js. So let's say we will pass something like a name. We'll pass a name. So we'll store a name. This is a simple normal variable. So this is all plain simple JavaScript that I'm dealing with, starting from very basic level, just to show how Node.js as a programming language, as a very strong programming language, how does it work? Because very basic level, it has to input output. That's what it has to interact with the operating system. It has to do the server side thing because server side thing will involve interacting with the operating system. Now we'll do this name and then again we'll do the process. From the process, we'll take the arguments, argv, argument variables. And among the argument variables, now see, this is before running. Okay. Now whenever we are running this, we are typing node and we are saying the file name. So node is the first command that is we are passing. That is, this is the first argument. And one, that is 1.js or 1, it is the another second argument. So these arguments are the form of array. So argv 0 will be node and argv 1 will be the parameter and whatever we'll pass next to it, like say my name. So this will be the third parameter. So that will be argv 2. Now what you want to do is that you want to print this particular on a screen. Say hello. And whatever the name was provided. Okay, we'll save it. And now what we'll do is that we'll try to run it. Now let's try running it without any parameters. And what it will do is it will give a node 1. So we haven't passed any value, any parameter. It's giving us undefined. Hello, undefined. We don't want it to be undefined. Let's give it my name. And I want him to wish me hello. So it's hello Vivek. So this is how we interact with the arguments passed along with the command. that is node 1. Okay, as I was telling, 0 and 1 will obviously be taken, because 0, if we give over here 1 and we'll just comment out this line, we'll try running it. We have to print something. Yeah, right. We'll remove this hello and we'll just print this whatever this name is, but taking the argument 1. We'll run it and it will give this one, but this is the path of the file name, because this is the second parameter. See, the second parameter here is the file name. Okay, and if what will happen if we give 0, that is the first parameter, it will give the node, where the node exe is located, whichever it's executing. Now what we will do is that, this is the normal input output, input how we do, we can do like this input, or in we'll do the standard input also. So what we'll do is that this time we'll take the name from the standard input stream. So that will be, so first for that, first of all, what we need to do is now this input stream is kind of a prompt. So for this prompt, we'll do a process dot stdin dot on. Now whenever there is a data, we are getting a data. So it will keep on asking for the prompts for input, and wherever as user enters something and enters this callback function, or this is a callback function which I was telling about. So this is the how the standard JavaScript callback function works. So what it will do is that we'll just do a console.log this particular. Now it has to be, this function will be getting passed data. So this data will get printed. That's it. Let's try running it. Okay, now it's asking for anything. We'll give say Vivek. It will print. Now see these are difference. It's not printing the exact string because we haven't converted this buffer information. Now everything in files is form of hexadecimal buffers. So we'll do a dot two string. We'll save it, we'll do again, we'll try to do, we'll now see passing Vivek, it's printing Vivek, awesome. So this is how the capturing the input stream. Now this will continue going on and on all till the time we can provide the data. So it will always be looking for getting the data, this input stream. Say next time we say it's the 7 minute, it will print 7 minutes. So this is how we are doing it. Input stream. In the next, we'll take up how to read from a file. Thank you all. Please press the like button and subscribe. Thank you.